County border battle. Independence versus Summit High School tonight on this opening night of football in Williamson County. It's the 21st. I'm Michael Williams alongside my buddy Paul Brees. And Paul, talk to us a little bit about what we need to know as these two teams take the field.
I mean, what we know is we have football. How about that?
We do have football.
And it is a border battle. So, again, these two schools, not in the same region, not even the same classification, but yet there's no love lost between them. I think what we're going to see here is this. Listen, Summit, they're going to have a target on their back this year, Michael Williams, because they were the state 5A runner-up last year. I know it's hard to believe when people say that out loud. They're like, what, Summit was in the state championship last year?
Absolutely, my friends.
These Indy Eagles also coming in, they went a game deep last year, I believe, before losing to Brentwood in the second round of the state. Indy with a 7-5 record last year. And again, just like you talked about, no love lost between these two, separated by about 10 minutes of driving time. But this is the border battle, and it's great to have football back again.
What does this Summit rivalry mean to you?
A lot, you know. We don't like them, they don't like us, and that's definitely a game where you know it's gonna be packed. All of Spring Hill, Thompson Station's gonna be there, so it's just a good environment, and it's a great game to play in.
You know, it's kind of a big deal, obviously, because it's the one school that we're main rivals against in the World Cup.
I mean, it's tradition. I mean, you get hype before, like you have the hype week throughout the entire week, Twitter war. I mean, normally a pep rally, but I mean, it's just tradition. You can't not love the rivalry.
Going through the banner, going out of that field for the first time in Independence for you, how was that? How did that feel?
I mean, it's just electric with everybody. You know, you got all the guys around you, you're all screaming, yelling at each other. I mean, just the whole vibe around it, it's just electric. It's awesome.
Take us to the end of the first. Jackson Campbell, all the way up the middle, 8 yards away, touchdown, Independence. So that will take us to the half. Independence in this border battle with a 14-6 lead over the Summit Spartans. Campbell again, rolling to his right, lofting into the corner of the end zone. Trey Hartwell making a name for himself in this opening game. And Campbell, he'll roll to his left, fires over the middle,
wide open,
wide open, and in the end zone.
Tina, number 7.
Wade looking.
Didn't force anything, Dustin.
Rolls to his right, fires back to his left, and that one is caught. Oh. Touchdown, Summit. He'll take it himself, and up the gut, and Wade will score! Summit on top, 40-34, 2 seconds remaining.
Good blocking.
Fires down to his left.
Oh, no!
Cross is incomplete, and the Spartans will take the victory in this border battle.
So, the game, you know, we were up big, then lost that lead. How did you feel after that game? What was kind of going through your head? What were your emotions after
that? I wasn't too happy, of course. Couldn't sleep at all that night. I just feel like we're the better team, you know? And so it stinks when, you know, you're the better team. You probably should have won, and we let that one go. But you know what? We built some character off that loss, so we're looking forward to having a good season.